Good afternoon. So the title of this presentation is Towards High Quality Industry Ready Linguistic Linked License Data. And as the title suggests, it will be focused on one of the aspects that will make linguistic resources available for the industry to be used, namely the licensing aspects. And we will not preach that resources have to be licensed, but we will show also the opportunities of licensing linguistic resources at different granularity levels and how this can be, how can this create new business opportunities. This work is the result of a cooperation between the Ontology Engineering Group, where I belong to, and Universitat Bielefeld, and actually is the outcome of more discussions between the members of the partners of the LEADER project. The LEADER project is an FP7 European project, which shall be duly presented tomorrow at 9 o'clock, so please don't be late, by Asunción Gómez, so you will know more about it. But I will just say a few words about the LEADER project. And remember that the main purpose of this project, in a word, is to expose linguistic resources as linked data, create a community around it, discover use cases coming from the industry, from real scenarios, from real settings, and declaring an architecture for exposing linguistic resources as linked data, as well as declaring a roadmap, providing guidelines, etc. You are all invited to participate in the discussions in this group. In particular, you can join the W3C community group, where we are holding all the discussions. And the participation is free for everybody, so you are invited to participate. For those who are not acquainted with the concept of linked data, I will just say that linked data is not a format, it's just a manner of exposing data, of publishing data, following a very few simple rules. Namely, expose use URIs and IRIs to identify your resources. Expose them and make them available through HTTP protocol. And the most important of all, connect the resources so that the resources make a cloud. And transform a web of documents that you can see in this slide, where the Wikipedia entry for Tim Berners-Lee is connected, perhaps, to a web page within the W3C, perhaps is connected, is linked to the Amazon page of his book, Weaving the Web. These links are already there in the HTML documents as hyperlinks, and they are linking documents. By moving to linked data, we are not creating a web of documents, but a web of data, where the connections are made explicit according to some well-known vocabularies. The terms are recognized by everybody, and we can extract knowledge from it. In this case, instead of the Wikipedia page of Tim Berners-Lee, we could have the DBpedia page of Tim Berners-Lee. And not only humans could take advantage of the web, but also machines. So, having data on the web is wonderful, specifically for linguistic resources. It's good to have connected the dictionary with the lexicon, with the corpus. And there are already many, many resources publicly available. But there are also many resources which are not available because the owners, the content creators, those who have created the linguistic resource deem as a valuable resource, something that has costed money to make, and they do not want to disclose it for free. So Some of the data is open data. You have some advantages, you gain visibility, you encourage the use, but some other data is not publicly available in the web, perhaps because of the fear that a business opportunity will be lost. We believe that this can be, this hurdle can be overcome, and by licensing the resources, they will be better consumed, and also business opportunities will not prevent, you will not refrain from publishing your work because you fear that others will make bad use of it. Currently, the state of affairs is not very good regarding licensing. This image shows the linked open data cloud as it was a few months ago, 1 year ago, where you can see the different resources connected and colored according to the license with which they have been exposed. So there are many resources published in the public domain. In the public domain means that you can do whatever you like with it. There are some others that are published with some restrictions. These restrictions can be as simple as please attribute the authorship, or can be harder, like you cannot make commercial use of this resource. And there are many others who have not a license at all. This is not industry ready. If in a real scenario you find a resource online, a linguistic resource, and you want to make use of it, you will not be able to do it unless it's licensed, because you will have fear to be sued. So what is perfectly possible in an academic environment, oh, I see a resource, I use it. In a commercial environment, it is not. You can see in this slide some statistics about how is the linked open data cloud being actually licensed. And you see that there are some resources that are actually not open. It is not considered open when you declare a non-commercial restriction, because you are preventing resources to be used jointly, because if one of them is declared as non-commercial and another is simply as has another restriction, these two resources cannot be combined and publicly exposed again. There are some compatibility problems between licenses. In particular, the linguistic resources, they have formed also their small cloud, where you can see here some lexica, some corpora, and so on and so forth. And we made the analysis on how linguistic resources have been licensed. The results are in this slide. And you see that there are many resources that are open, but there are also many who have some restrictions, or they haven't declared at all the license. From here, we encourage you to always publish the license along with the resource. Otherwise, it will not be used. So we claim that linguistic resources should be published with the 3LD paradigm. They have to be licensed and as linked data. That's why we said linguistic linked licensed data. Linguistic linked licensed data. So the procedure to follow is always to add the rights metadata to the dataset description, to use standard predicates to declare the rights so that they can be understood by machines automatically, and if an open license suffices for you, use one of the famous URIs, well-known URIs for licenses. In particular, if you are using Creative Commons licenses, use licenses from the version 4.0. Why? Because this is particularly important for our context. Before Creative Commons 4.0, licenses were being ported to the different jurisdictions. they had been ported to more than 50 jurisdictions, it means that there was a license for the Spanish jurisdiction, there was another license written for the United Kingdom jurisdiction, etc. And if you were targeting audience in different countries, in theory, you should declare your linguistic resource to each of these ports. This has been overcome in Creative Commons version 4.0, where the legal text has been written so that it's compatible with most of the jurisdictions. And in case you don't want an open model and you want to make profit of your resource, profit, economical profit, then you can declare your license with more detail by using one language that allows you to do so, that is the ODRL, Open Digital Rights Language. With this language, you can specify that you are selling your resource, and not only that you are selling the whole data set, but that you are selling perhaps fractions of it. Imagine that you have a dictionary and you want to expose for free the meaning of a word, but you want to sell the synonym or the antonym. By providing the linguistic resource as a linguistic license linked data, you can do it. You can declare, I give you for free this, but if you want this other resource, if you want the synonym, if you want the antonym, you will have to pay. We have been working on this in a small demo that you can, whose URL you can see here, conditional.linkdata.s, where the licenses are driving a conditional access system. So this is important. The same document that serves to declare the license in legal terms can also be used to drive a conditional access system and will disclose data or not according to the policies that you have written. And the policies can be as complex as it is free if you are in Spain, but you will have to pay if you are abroad. Or is it, I give you access to this resource, but only for a limited period of time. So when you declare your resource, I don't know if you see, just you can see it. If you declare your resource, in this case as RDF, you see here an excerpt of RDF, you can declare the provenance. You can see it in blue below. It was generated at this time. It was generated by me. Possibly you can sign the document, digitally sign. And also you can declare very, very specific conditions. For example, in this example, we see here how we have a linguistic resource that is only available to Spanish research institutions. This is very interesting because this has a legal value if there is a text behind that you can also attach very easily, but also it can be enforced part of it. So I cannot evaluate that you are a research institution, but I can evaluate that you are accessing from a Spanish IP. And you see here how, with this vocabulary, you can say that this is available for Spanish research institutions. As an example, we have exposed a data set, in this case a geographic data set, as linked data. We are showing some properties related to Barcelona. So we are showing that is that part of Catalonia, that is a province, that is the main municipality of the province called Barcelona, etc. And below, in the red square, you see that there are some information that I'm not disclosing. In this case, the geometric, the GPS, the geographical coordinates are not being provided unless you pay or unless you satisfy any some other requirements. I am also hiding the links. Perhaps I could link this entity, Barcelona, to the counterpart in DBpedia. I am not disclosing this information because I think it's very valuable and I want to offer it with a payment modality. So if I download the data, I will see that the geometry is hidden. I just see an offer. An administrator could come here, declare that I offer the mappings or the geographical coordinates for a price. In this case, let's say, or that I can disclose the whole, I'm finishing 30 seconds, that I'm disclosing the whole data set for a fixed price. So perhaps I say, I sell you all the mappings for 10 euros, but if you just want a mapping with 1 cent, I will be happy. And the system administrator will select the proper license. And the next time we access, we see in the green box the coordinates that before were hidden. You can. I encourage you to visit the demo. I will show you again the link for you to do it. And that was all I had to say. Thank you.